is taken in. It's complete. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. And that one results in 35 yards. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. To throw here on second and 10. Looking left sideline, it's complete. And he is out of bounds, just a yard or two shy of the 10. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just going to ask you, that wasn't the primary target, and he's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said,
It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota. The Vikings now heading on to the field. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
These are his numbers from last week's contest. 6 catches, 78 yards.
And that touchdown was his first of the year, and you know he's eager to get more of those.
He's got him. Got his man on the end route. Complete. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. And he will find his man on the end route. Complete. And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains. That's the number 2 receiver in the NFL in terms of yardage. And tell you what, a few more plays like that, he won't be number 2 for long.
But that's what often happens when you have competitors running around the field. These guys know where they stand in relationship to yardage, totals, numbers, the whole deal. And let's face it, all of them, they all want to be number 1. Well, he did almost everything right. Excellent coverage, breaks on the football, just unable to haul it in and take it the other way. So he dropped an interception. The key for him now, don't dwell on it. Just move on to the next play.
Back to throw now on second and 10. Wide open receiver complete. 17 yards on the pickup there, and the drive will continue. So on that play, defense was in the zone. They ran a crossing route offensively, but the defense there, you got to be good with communication, don't you?
You certainly do, and it's not something that is really evident when you watch it on the screen. But everyone's talking, communicating, pointing, and it keeps you from chasing receivers because you have a specific zone you have to cover. When a receiver's in your zone and he crosses to another one, you got to let your guy know. They got a completion there, but I like the discipline they show to stay in their proper areas and then make the tackle.
He's got his man. It's taken in for a Viking touchdown. And he is a reliable target. They like to get him involved. They got him involved there for the score. Now the Vikings offense works their way back onto the field. They're starting to put some space here. In the first quarter, they didn't look so hot offensively. This second quarter, though, they've looked really good.
They've jumped in the saddle in a big way now, and now they're in full gallop. I mean, before, kind of cantering around a little bit, right, trying to feel their way, not getting done what they wanted to. But somehow they put it together with play calling, execution, and now there's a pretty big gap.
And they'll look to make that gap even bigger here. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks.
That looked like a pretty good route combination there because you've got to find a way to clear the guy running the drag, because when you do, you just put the ball on him and then let him run.
Yeah, he's got some space. Looking left side, he's got it complete. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. 11 yards for number 11. So 5 plays on this drive, Charles. All passes, all completions. And just like that, they're in the red zone.
And don't you think the playbook opens up a little bit more now? Because all they've done is throw the football. If you want to run it now.
It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota. And partner, they found a gap there on the post pattern, and it was in the middle third of the field.
And that's really difficult to do because ordinarily the safeties are back there to prevent that happening, but they found the opening and exploited it.
Around the NFL, they're in the second quarter at Lambeau. Early lead in that one for the Packers. I have a feeling that one's going to stay tight throughout. We'll continue to monitor. Now the Vikings offense gets set to take over here. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
Man, confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them. They feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go around. And now with that completion, he's north of 200 yards here in the first half.
And he's going to break our statistician, Marvin, isn't he? Because Marvin right now is just tallying it up. Hope his hand doesn't hurt too much doing this or keeps hitting the calculator. But my goodness, what a start he is off to. By the end of this game, he could have monster numbers. He just wants to continue to be accurate.
So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. He's to the 10. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling. This offense can certainly move quickly when they want to. 3 plays, 3 pass completions. In the blink of an eye, they've got a first and goal.
Almost felt like a lightning bolt hitting this game, didn't it? For them to get downfield that quickly. And now first and goal.
And oh, it'll be intercepted. Able to get there and pick it. The Vikings offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add.
And the Niners get there and bring him down. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. That goes for a gain of 31. And he can't quite bring it in. Might have heard footsteps there across the middle. Second down.
Right up to that point, I was about to say he's had a pretty good half catching the football, but let's just be honest about it. He should have caught that one.
And he knows that. That was one right. And he's going to go down. Back near midfield at the 49. Solomon Thomas in there to get him for a loss of 5.
All right, here we go. Green, 39.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And that will be incomplete. Four ticks left here on the clock. Out come the Vikings. They'll have it first on offense as we begin the third. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get it, push it, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot. But they have to feel good about how they've been throwing it overall. It looked like they had something there, but I think that he was thinking about running with the football before he actually hauled it in. And that
under a heavy rush, and down he goes. And now out comes Minnesota. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. And passing yardage-wise, now up over 350 in this game. Pretty nice performance.
Definitely that, which usually means you're putting a lot of pressure on guys trying to cover. If you're a defensive back and they put over 350 yards on you, you've had a long day. The key to everything, if you're doing it without throwing interceptions or turning the ball over.
He'll look to throw. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and eight.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15, just shy of the 10. And now a first down following that long gain. Now back to throw. Oh, incomplete. A turnover would have really helped there. Almost intercepted. Instead, it's just second down.
Not only did they drop what looked like an interception in the end zone, they blew a golden opportunity to shift the momentum.
Blitz coming, and down he goes.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. And this is going to be incomplete. Comes Minnesota, and they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had the field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for three, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get three, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
Throw is going to be incomplete.
This defense could use some more of these types of plays. How about him reading it, driving on the football, and he's right there for the pass breakup.
Here we go. Finds a seam inside the 40. And he's brought down. They give him 17 yards that time as that'll move the chains. Quickly here, and that's complete. And he'll go down at the 28. Give him nine there on the first down completion. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Back now here in Santa Clara. It's the Vikings in possession of the football and the lead. They'll be looking to add to that total as we begin quarter number four. Second down, Cook, and he's brought down. 12 yards there as they move the chains. And I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely, you want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense.
And he will score. Touchdown, Vikings. Comes Minnesota, and they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch counterpunch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
We'll see if they dial it up this drive. And he can't hang on. That's definitely going to be one he wishes he had back. Incomplete in the end zone.
Not too many missteps in the red zone thus far. He was going for his fifth touchdown pass. His man couldn't shake free there. But boy, you know he's going to take another shot before this one's over.
Yeah, exactly, because you know he's got his man. It's taken in for a Viking touchdown. Now the Minnesota offense set to take over again. They've really distanced themselves. They have put the pedal to the metal, I guess, so to speak.
So definitely have them in the rearview mirror, don't they? I mean, you're exactly right. Being able to string together these drives that end up in points, it's almost like a run in basketball to create that distance, and they're on a really big-time one right now.
It becomes contagious, doesn't it?
It absolutely does, because oftentimes it translates to your defense as well, because they're excited about getting the ball back for their offense that's playing so well.
Well, they are clicking right now. 23 yards on the play. Well, there's your leading receiver in the NFL in terms of yardage, putting on another clinic, well over 100 yards.
Are we taking notes? We should be, right? Because I'm going to go back and watch this tape and really enjoy what I'm seeing. The route running, competing for the football, just breaking down a defense.
No dice this go around. He's hit behind the line and taken down. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Brent, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
That one good for 17 yards, and now they've got it first and goal. Oh, he had 6 points in his hands there. Couldn't hang on. Second down. Yards still to go here on second and goal. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota. And now out comes Minnesota. They had the double-digit lead at halftime, and they have continued to roll. They're hard to stop right now.
I think what we're seeing is an example of a team that has it figured out in this ballgame. And whatever the adjustments are the defense has made, hasn't fazed them at all. They either anticipated them, or they've been so far ahead that they just can't catch up.
Now it's just a search to add to the lead. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. And he's going to be out of bounds, but able to take it inside the 40-yard line. A very solid gain of 27. And on that last play there, he's over 400 yards passing now.
You know what that generally means?
Success.
That, and it means you really didn't miss opportunities. Usually very accurate. The ball's getting to the right place. Guys are making yardage after the catch to help you out that way. I mean, the whole team has picked it up. And don't forget, that means the offensive line has had to pass protect pretty well, too.
Yeah, everyone dialed in. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly. And now out comes Minnesota. They come into enemy territory, and I don't care what the matchup is in the National Football League. You're up like this late in the game on the road. This feels pretty good.
Oh, it feels fantastic. Anytime you get a road victory in the NFL, that's a big-time accomplishment. And to do it this convincingly, that just tears up the script that every home team has, which is nobody comes into our house and pushes us around. They took care of business today.
Yeah, they pushed around, and now the final stages of this one. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Looking to throw. And that one is incomplete. He just dropped it. But they're up big on the scoreboard, so maybe he can chuckle about later.
You can't be precise with your throws, especially in this situation. You're inside the 10-yard line going into the end zone. But sometimes the emotion, the excitement, sometimes the decisions just aren't made very well because of that.
And this will be caught, and the carnage continues. It's another touchdown. Starting to really smell a 4-0 start right now. Yeah. And out now come the Vikings. They have the dream scenario you hope for coming into the game. Just one kneel here, and this game should be over.
And it's always the final play of preparation each week.
And they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals. They are, by the way, into the fourth quarter now in Oakland. And it was the Chiefs who emerged victorious. A win would be their second on the young season. I tell you, Charles, you play to the final whistle, I get that, but there are a few folks that might not be. A big offensive experience.